I'll call the Pownal Select Board to order 7:10, March 31st, 2016. Agenda approval, minutes, warrants, mail, old business, new business. Is agenda approval? Old business was post-road foreman position, solar array for the transfer station, Oak Hill School drainage, and Hoozick River hydro lease. Anything else?
Update on PFOA.
Yes, and we have a gentleman here from the EPA, Vince Yarno.
Vermont EPC.
And he's going to update us on the PFOA at Pownal Village.
He's from the state.
Right.
Wait towards all the Oak Hill.
It's unlocked.
No.
So are you going to approve the agenda?
I move to go ahead and approve the agenda. I sent her out to get the pictures for Oak Hill. I blew them all up.
So you got new ones, because I have them on the table.
All in favor?
Yeah, I got them. I'll call her.
Who seconded that?
I think Henry did. You seconded that, Henry?
Do you second?
I did.
Okay.
Steve, did you have something you wanted to add?
Oh, I just wondered if I could get on the agenda.
Good.
I did add him for next week, but because the ACO is coming in.
Okay.
Board's budget.
So, you want to hold him off till next week?
Yeah.
Or you want to have him talk today?
I don't care.
It's up to you.
That's fine, I'll wait till next week.
Okay.
Okay, well then, I guess it would clear that issue right up, maybe. Okay, now, approve the minutes for March 17th, 2016.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All in favor?
Aye.
Warrants. Accounts payable, $11,728.86. Payroll, $9,767.08.
So moved.
Second.
All in favor?
Sorry.
Aye. We had a letter here from, we got a notification here from Bennington County Sheriff's Office. And it, 3911, hangups, four assist, agency assist, one public assist, one burglary alarms, three suspicious events, four accidents, property damage only, one agency assist, fire rescue, two motor vehicle complaints, one noise complaint, six VIN verifications, nine directed patrols all over town, traffic stops all over town, and one aggravated domestic traffic tickets as follows. 17 speeding tickets, two no registration, four operating license suspended, one no license, 28 written verbal warnings. Had property checks at all the local places. And they've been following the buses and being visible on Route 7 and 346. So we, that's their report. And agency of transportation, municipal grant. What's that, Linda? We just put in for it? Is that the story?
Those were the two grants that the board was asking what was submitted for grants this year. There's a structures grant for Mount Anthony, There's two sections of Class II paving on North Pownal Road. Those are submitted for consideration for Town of Pownal this year.
Okay, this is a...
Question, the one on Mount Anthony, didn't we already have that awarded last year?
This
is the second one.
Second one.
Second one, okay.
Yeah, Town Good. Road 5, Mount Anthony Road.
Great.
That's a culvert,
yes.
84 by 60.
Yep.
Replacement's 14 by 6 by 7. Then North Pownal Road. So them have been submitted. Agency of Transportation, Robert Green here wants a overweight permit from the town.
Move to approve it.
Second. All those in favor?
Aye.
Aye.
Okay. Got a letter here from the town office people. Frank Lamb. The minutes are here. The committee discussed the new building cost and agreed they seem high for this area. Dave Thomas volunteered to talk to area contractors, plumbers, electricians, and reduce the cost to a more reasonable level. The group agreed to have David proceed. The report came to us. The committee agreed to remove the blacktopping, the cupola, and only pour the pad for the elevator shaft and remove the walking path from the project to reduce costs as needed. Dave will check on cost reductions and removing these items. He'll look at the cost of metal roofing. The committee talked about the roof building and the tour with the state fire inspector. It appears that John Chapman will be drawing the plans for the new office renovations. The committee requested John review his plans with them, with us, before they are passed on to the selectmen, so with the committee. This is the same procedure followed with the new building. Finally, the committee looked at tax income that would be lost from the roost property, and that's $3,000. The next meeting will take place when we have information to review. So that's a report from the town office committee. The zoning administrator for 1-2-2016. We had number of applications 8, number accepted 8. Number of permits, 3 verifications, 2 permits. Number 4 was the DRB, 3. They calls on land use for listings. Talk to the people, the status, talk to the people about the subdivision rules. Usual calls asking if permits needed. That's from the zoning administrator. Green Lantern, they're writing to notify us that a petition has been filed with Vermont Public Service Board today seeking approval for the installation of a 500 kilowatt group net metering system to be located at 536 Dean View Road in Pownal. Initially described in our pre-filing notice letter to you of December 8th, 2015. If you'd like an electronic copy, just send this one. Comments on the application may be filed with the Public Service Board within 21 days. And Bill Scully, we've been talking about the hydro. We're a little bit, or maybe a lot confused. There's a lot of lawyer talk and I don't understand too much of it myself, and I think the lawyer is kind of baffled a little too on some of these things. The EPA is involved with they're looking for dewatering sites and all this other stuff. So you got anything to comment on that, Nelson?
I would say at this point it's still in discussion with the Agency of Natural Resources, the EPA, and Bill Scully from the point of actually removing what they have to remove and take care of. There's also the issue of the contract that he's looking for us to sign for the use of the property, in which the lawyer has addressed several things that we should review and look at in more detail. One of the things that I was thinking of was if the board would approve it, is trying to get a meeting where I could sit down with the EPA and Bill Scully and understand this better myself and then report back to you guys.
That would be very beneficial, because I don't think, there's three here, I don't think we're anywhere near up to speed on that. It's way too much that you can read it, but it comes from everywhere, and it doesn't really, it's tough for me to understand anyway.
Well, there's a lot of legalese, and the key is our lawyer is making sure we're protected, which is what he should be doing.
That's right.
And Bill Scully is trying to make sure that the Agency of Natural Resources and the EPA needs are met so he can proceed. And I, what I like to do is try to mesh them and get a good understanding of what that all means. So when we talk about it, we can say, well, here's the steps that need to be taken. And at this point, I just don't feel comfortable saying where we're at.
I move to support Nelson to get down there and take care of that.
Is a second on that?
Second.
All in favor?
I'll try to say something.
This annual financial plan for the town highways. This is our plan that we've submitted or whatever?
Yes.
All right.
It's going to be submitted.
It's going to be submitted.
I move that we sign it.
Second.
I'll sign it.
All in favor?
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All right. This here was more for that hydro, to go to that. There's a vacancy on the Board of Selectmen. Please contact the town office for further information. Forward a letter of interest to the Pownal Board of Selectmen, or email pownal@comcast.net.
That's posted around town as well, right?
Of course.
Good.
Okay. Now, we have a gentleman here from the EPA, Vince Charnel.
He's not from the EPA.
DEC, the state. Department of Environmental Conservation, State of Vermont.
Oh, Department of
Conservation, yes.
All right, okay. So DEC then, right?
Yep.
DEC, okay. He's going to give us an update on PFOA problems down in Pownal Village, the chemical.
Okay. So, I'll just go through this, and if you guys got questions, go ahead, feel free to stop me. Right now, where we're at, we finished up the testing down there at the private wells. 58 wells in South Pownal have been tested. We expect the results back in 7 to 10 days, so 7 to 10 days from Tuesday, hopefully by the end of next week. The remaining requests that have came in since the testing was concluded yesterday, we hope to do them this coming Monday. Okay. As we were discussing earlier, the EPA tested up this area, Pownal Center, yesterday, which they did the town office, Cozy Meadows, and
Pownal Elementary School, the daycare. Another location on Center Street and another location on the corner lot on North Pownal Road.
Okay. So she's more versed on that because, like I said, the EPA did it. But those results, again, will be back in 7 to 10 days also. So that may be the end of next week or maybe the beginning of the following week. Alternative water sources are being discussed every day up north by the leadership. I'm not sure what they all are. I mean, I've been told a source from Williamstown, possibly. Also with the filtration systems, whether it be put on the municipal system itself, or if they're going to be put separately on, you know, the homes themselves. Of course, that, depending on that, I'm talking about the wells, the filtration systems.
Correct.
At the homes.
Yes.
Okay. The municipal filtration system could possibly have be put in also. So that's just in the planning stages, and that's going to take a bit from what I was told, 4 to 8 weeks. So I
heard on the news tonight that when they were reporting the Hoosick Falls one, that the filtration system they put on over there actually worked and they're coming back.
Yeah, they just reported it that it's full up, I guess, as of yesterday. So I don't know exactly how long that took, but
I don't know. I know they talked about it for a while. It's been weeks, right? Since
it's been a long time.
Been a long time.
Not a long time, but
it may end up down here that the short term solution be the filtration system put on Fire District 2's water supply for the municipal system, and then if the wells come back at an elevated level, then the separate filtration systems will be put at the residences. But again, waiting on those tests for the private wells to come back. Been talking to Greg, who's been doing an absolutely fantastic job down there, about finding somebody to assist him, because he's not going to, you know, for whenever he may not be around, or if, cross the fingers, it doesn't. But this area up here comes up above the advisory level. Because he's, you know, if it happens up here, he's just not going to be able to do it alone. So he's gonna work on that, finding somebody to assist him. Okay. The water buffaloes, we have 6 water buffaloes, which are the National Guard's 400-gallon mobile water tanks. We now have 6 down there. We have 1 at Green Mountain Mobile Home Park, 1 at Alta Gardens, and 1 at the Burdick Mobile Home Park. We have the 1 at the Rescue Squad. 1 is at the Pownal Pets Kennel, and 1 is at a residence down off of 346 who has some ponies, and I'm not sure what she has down there. But she requested directly to DEC for water buffalo, so 1 was delivered there. There was some concerns and complaints about the chlorine levels in the water buffaloes, and I'm sure you may or may not have heard about that. We had, I guess, a couple individuals complain about the chlorine level. We've since brought the chlorine level down. Yesterday, we drained some of the tanks. And the reason that happens is you're transporting water from one source to another, and it's recommended that, you know, the chlorine be a little bit higher, to just because of the transport and logistics that we want to make sure that, you know, everything's okay in the water. And one of the issues was when the National Guard cleaned the tanks, they put some water in the tanks and they put the chlorine in and they drove them down here so it sloshes around and cleans the tank, and they got down there and drained the tanks, and then we filled them with the 4,600-gallon water tanker that we had come all the way from Underhill. And unfortunately, some or most of them tanks had some chlorine residual in it, that when we put the new water in it, the chlorine level was kind of high. And you could, in some of them, you could smell it pretty good and taste it a little bit, which it's nothing that's going to make anybody sick, but it was making some folks uncomfortable. So we did what we could to bring that down, and it's at a more satisfactory level. So hopefully we got a handle on that. The water buffalo thing, we were fortunate in North Bennington, where there's town water, town highway people, and I'm sorry, I'm not exactly what entity they work for there, but were able to assist, and they were able to fill their own buffaloes and move them around because they had vehicles with the hookup. So that was much easier up there. Unfortunately, down here, and I talked to Jason about a vehicle to possibly move the buffaloes around stuff, but the Townal Pound vehicles don't have the hookup. So hopefully by sometime tomorrow, not hopefully, by sometime tomorrow, this whole water buffalo thing and how they're going to get refilled and moved around if they have to be, I'm going to have that rectified, and I'll communicate that with Craig. So I've been here since last Friday. I live up in Westford, 3.5 hours from here. I went home Saturday, but I've been here since Easter, kind of getting things rolling and, you know, trying to get everything organized and everything. So hopefully by tomorrow, things have kind of slowed down a little bit the last couple days. So hopefully tomorrow by that, again, not hopefully, but when I leave, Craig will have all the information he needs and contact numbers if any issues come up. And again, we'll cross our fingers that the wells come back below the 20 parts per million. I don't know if I'm leaving anything out.
I think you had everything.
Any questions? Last thing. I'm not going to be around here next week, so we're not really going to have a presence down there. So again, Craig will have all the contact numbers, and if any issues.
How will the notification come as far as the results with us?
I'm not. I can try to find that out tomorrow, because when it initially happened up there, they were hand delivering them, and we didn't have enough staff to get everything out quick enough, you know, and the results were coming back, and you know, when you're trying to hand deliver them and some folks aren't home and people are getting the results and these other people are wanting to know where theirs are, and well, we were at their house and they weren't there, so they've done it different ways up there. Then they started doing it by phone call, but that's something I'll ask, and I'll get back to you and Craig on that.
Okay, that's notifying the people. How would the town itself know the situation, whether it's escalating or whether there was nothing found?
One second here. That I'm not sure, but how did they initially contact you guys?
By phone.
To?
You got a phone message from Trish.
I got a phone message.
Okay.
My only thing is, if she wants to communicate with Linda, that's fine, and then she can email us or however, you know.
It works best.
And one contact's probably better than.
If that works, then we won't mess with that.
Okay.
And I'll just remind.
EPA and DEC contacted me.
Okay, good.
They both have your email, right? Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Actually, Leslie was one of them.
Yeah, I got a question on this. Transfer station, our old town dump.
Mm-hmm.
I believe some waste from one wire was put in that facility over there years back.
There's test wells around that site?
Yeah,
because we have to test wells
there. I'm just wondering if, and there's. Property owners, I mean, within.
Well, they're right on the border.
A few hundred, yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I'm on the border.
Yeah, okay. I can answer some
but,
of that.
I don't have any homes there, you know what I'm saying. There was a person at the meeting down here on Maple Grove Road that was concerned. That,
that concern has been brought to DEC's attention when Trish was here on Wednesday.
Okay.
And Tom Chewy spoke with her also about testing over at the transfer station.
Okay.
That's being set up.
Okay.
Okay.
Good. Okay. Good. I just want to be sure
and I'll remind them that was brought up again today, just so.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sure.
I'm sure it was being scheduled, but just to follow up.
Yep. Okay.
I think the meeting went fairly well.
Last night.
You talked the night the public meeting.
Oh, the public meeting. Yeah, you guys were all there. I mean.
Yeah. No, I thought that went. You know, it was a lot of people and a lot of questions, but everything went. I thought very, very smooth. Or
professionally.
All the questions were answered, and you know, I mean, nobody was rushed. Or try to be shut off, is that the right words? Or I mean, everything was dealt very, very professionally and very good, I thought.
Yeah. Yeah. And our Commissioner Alyssa Scher, the young woman, unfortunately, she's had a little bit of practice after the North Bennington. And she's done a pretty good job.
I thought everything went super. I really do. I thought people were, and I think everyone there pretty well was.
Most everybody,
satisfied, right? I mean,
yeah.
Right.
And also, which made me think of last night. I don't know if you're aware, we met with Craig and I and Jason, met with the other fire departments, and we've come up, because this distributing the bottled water every night from 3 to 7 is getting a bit much on these guys. So we had a meeting last night, and we got more people involved and made a new schedule. Contact up there, our media contact, she was supposed to get that out today. It's supposed to go in the banner and front porch forum and all this stuff, the new schedule, which is going to be Monday, Wednesday, Friday, Saturday, 4 to 7, instead of every day 3 to 7, which should be sufficient, hopefully. So, in case you get that question up here.
One of the other sites they were talking about testing was the Cedar Hill area in the old Linekill area because of experimentation that went on out there years ago. I know that I went over to talk at the desk, and they told me that they were already looking at that. I just want to make sure that they do that.
Yeah, because you're talking about the old Dodge property, or some of it may still be some Dodge property.
Yeah.
Our folks have been on that. I don't know where they've gotten with it.
Okay.
I know initially they were refused
access. Okay.
But then they changed their mind. So,
right.
One of the properties, anyways.
Okay.
So. Again, I guess if you have any additional questions, you can contact Trish.
Actually, the office has been relatively quiet with the telephone inquiries. It's another reason why the public meeting went very, very well. I do have extra handouts available, and I have the list of contact numbers.
The other thing I need to mention is the 211. Were you made aware of that, the 211 number?
Yeah, I don't get that one out.
Okay.
Should I be?
Well, yeah.
Only because I know you don't really get to talk to a person.
Yeah, you should. I've tested them several times. Called them because there was.
Is it working?
Yes. So 211 is basically an informational source for the public. I was told it runs 24/7. We had some glitches last weekend where I was calling from on my cell phone. I was getting New Hampshire, but that supposedly has been worked out. So if the public wants additional information and, you know, they don't want to track down Craig or call DEC, the 211, we're feeding them all the information they have. We have, I'm sorry. And folks can call 211 at 24/7 is what I was told to get updates on the status also. And I believe that information, that is on our website, the 211 number, the DEC Vermont, the other source is the Vermont DEC website, for all the up-to-date information. I don't know if we can put that on the side or get that word out down there. They should have everything.
And the Department of Health in Bennington has a district.
Has.
Information on PFOA.
Yeah, the Department of Health has the health-related questions. Folks can call the Vermont Department of Health. I had a couple folks come in down there upset about health concerns, and I directed them to the Vermont Department of Health. So, and they've been up there, the Bennington branch, and they've been really good to responding to Shannon Tatro.
Okay. Is there any web pages or anything like that where people can go for any information that's down here, or is it just general?
Well, the No. The Vermont DEC website, and if you, I wish I had the exact link with me, but I apologize for not having that. But if you, boy, folks, if you were to search PFOA Pownal, I think that's, yeah, it'd pop right up. And when you get on the Vermont DEC webpage, I think it's right dead in the middle, PFOA. And you click on that, and then it's the whole PFOA page, and it has a section to click on for Pownal and one for Bennington. So it's right there.
Pretty well updated.
Yeah, oh yeah, yeah, daily.
Okay,
yeah.
Good. Good for me.
Great.
Okay. Good job.
Thanks for that.
Yep.
Filling us in.
You were talking about that. Do you seem to have enough volunteers to help, or is that kind of...
It seems like it right now. I got an email earlier with some other names.
Seems to be coming together or whatever. Just, you know, because if you need more, we should keep it.
The thing, we did talk about some other groups,
but, you know.
But you have to be strong enough to be able to pick up cases of water. That's another issue. You have to be physical, you know.
Yeah, because we have a lot of folks that come in
heavy thing, lifting cases of water, so it's hard to ask, you know, the senior groups or...
Yeah, Bill Botso had suggested that, you know, some certain senior groups and
right.
Maybe not feasible.
But I do have a couple more names I did get.
You're absolutely right. I would never make it.
No, Rosemary Pelletier, she's a
Gilpin. She's on songs, yeah.
Gilpin?
Yes, that was another name, yes. Yeah.
Yeah. Use them, right?
Yes, definitely.
Why not? Yeah.
They
want to help.
Okay. Terrific. Okay. Thank you.
No, I think everybody seems to be on top. I mean, right?
Yeah.
I mean, we're moving forward quite rapidly. It seems to be anyway. So
yeah.
Very good.
About as fast as it can be.
All right.
All set.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Thanks, gentlemen.
Take it easy.
Have a good one.
See you later. All right, thanks.
Now, need a old business. The next item was solar, clean energy design group. This here is for over at the... used to be the dump, right? Landfill?
Yeah.
Whatever.
Transfer station,
whatever.
Yep.
Gotta call it, it's not what it is.
I move that you go ahead and sign it.
Second it.
Yep.
All in favor?
Aye.
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 That was looked at by Paul Gillis too. Am I saying that right, Nelson?
Yes,
so,
yeah.
Yes.
I mean, everything seems.
Did
to be...
we already move on the other one for the?
Yes.
The other one's been moved. On,
yep.
Yeah.
Ron signed it. It's already gone to Tryland.
Okay. So we want to get these.
So
in.
I just want to. We got
right,
two of
so
them.
So now we have two. This one will go out tomorrow, and then we'll wait for them to send them back to us signed,
okay.
Or if we need to negotiate or whatever.
We have two of them out there. Good.
Took quite a little while, but I guess we got them.
Well, we're moving now anyway,
yep.
So we don't want to miss out if we can get a benefit.
Yep.
Now, Oak Hill School Road Drainage.
I got some pictures here, and I think Linda's got them too, down that end. But these are the ones we took
yep,
that day.
Yeah, would be the same.
I wasn't sure if she was going to be able to print them out, so I printed them out too. Make sure.
We eventually got it.
We went over and looked at that
yep.
as a group, and again, and we had some thoughts. Of course, we don't have a roadmap. I think we came up with some that we ought to research 2-3 ideas we had there that would be. More cost effective and also do the job. We looked at the lines down underneath the, that, down where the old store used to be, all that, that big piece of blacktop, there's some drop basins in there, and it's all interhooked together. And there's ditching on the side here that we thought we could do some change in there. And divert a lot of that water so it would go into the existing system that's down there. That's what the thoughts were. Now, I'm not a highway engineer, but so where are we going to go there?
Well, I saw, as you stated, two options. One is to basically go up where we saw the first culvert issue and basically do what was discussed at the last meetings, put some catch basins and connect some to the next catch basin and so forth, down to the existing system that's already there. This would cut in half what we were talking about doing last time, if not even more than half, and basically do some proper ditching to make sure the catch basins would work. This would basically leave just about all the water from the other side except what comes down on that side of the road, and it's so steep there, they're going to get whatever runs off the bank anyways. There's nothing we can do about what's coming off their own bank. And it is a pretty large surface. But that's one option. The other was to go up and do some ditching, try and improve the water flow that is existing there, do a little more riprap on the high end where we took a picture that shows with the leaves and all the stuff. It should be a picture there.
The one that's going down through here, the one down through.
Yeah,
okay.
That basically shows going down through. There's a pretty good sized ditch there, so you can tell the water has flowed there pretty good and washed up. But there's some rock there, but there's not a lot of rock to slow things down.
Yeah.
So that was another option we were thinking of. Even if we did that in the short term, while we get bids and stuff for the bigger fix, it might be a plus. Those were the two things that I think we discussed when we were there.
I mean, I know we had Casey had had the guy from the state come down and look at it, and I'm not sure why he wouldn't have suggested we could tie into the existing drainage that's already there.
Yeah, well, we can ask.
It looks not real complicated to do that. I mean, it's not a.
Well, I think what this was quite a while ago when all that drainage was put in. He might not even understood what was there,
okay.
So he was looking at a solution.
Okay.
Without
I believe I understand he was just here 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, but this fix that's there now, drainage and stuff, was done.
They did that box culvert right there at the bottom of the hill.
Yeah, in the hole.
Or 7 years ago.
Yeah, it was quite a while ago. So I would say that they got to have the drawings to get to that. They can't be lost.
Right.
Maybe the thing to do is to talk to the state individual and see what he thinks of us tying into the existing system.
Yeah.
That way there, he gives us an answer. The pipe might be big enough, might not be big enough. But somebody went down and looked at it, where it came out. What size did you say the pipe was where the drain came out?
It's like 24 inch.
Looked like a 24 inch coming out of there.
Yeah. So
that's a big culvert.
Pretty big.
That'd take a lot of water.
Yeah, so asking the question might give us the answer. And then at that point, if he says yes, then I would say we do the move for the bid, because once we know what the price is, then we can make a better decision on how much we want to spend this year, or if it's a project we have to put in for a grant or something.
Well, I think we want to consider this where this these culverts are sending this water down these ditches. I mean, them ditches have been there since in the 30s.
Yep.
So, I mean, you know, this isn't something that just happened over the last 10 years. So, but I think that to divert this water. Now, the other thing that you didn't mention was is all the water that's going into them ditches come from the house right there. That's property. I don't know if they own that property or not.
Yeah, I don't know.
Okay. But then you've got school. The old school, okay. Now that has all been cleared, and that all slopes to guess where?
It all runs to 346.
All of it, that whole hill, okay. Now, I don't know what these ditches were. I don't know if they were if they were made from water or if they were actual ditches in the past. I don't know that. So, but I think that we should have, I think we should look into it. I think there's no question there's a problem with water.
Well, you brought up a good point, because right now we've got one person in here that's telling us what his water problems are. If we really think about it, if you go down near where the water system is, there's a couple houses there. They've come in and complained about water problems before, too, which is the ones that you're talking about from the Oak Hill School and,
right.
and the other steep thing. And the real change that's occurred is that our climate has changed enough that we have a lot more water falling in the last few years than had for 30 or 40 years. So people aren't used to the volume that we've been getting. But yeah, you're right, because when you open it up, there's not one house we're talking about there.
Yeah, there's a few of them. I mean, I didn't, you know, count them, or I didn't, you know, get into detail there, because Ronnie hit the nail on the head, I think, when he said, you know, we're not engineers, it's far from. But just to say, hey, listen, you know, you're going to throw a ton of money on something, and this is going to solve that problem. There may just be some other alternatives that will solve them for everyone.
And see, we may have to have, maybe this same guy from the stream alteration engineer, Josh Carval. He looked at this already.
Well.
And he's, well, of course, he said that the proposed repairs would not contain sediment from entering Ladbrook, so we may have to have them, you know, give us a design for
settlement
the sediment ponds or whatever. If they have to be a spot where the water will go,
this might get deeper.
The DIs also collect sediment also.
Yes, we know. Yes.
Yeah.
Each DI collects sediment also.
Yeah. Well, that's what I mean.
We need to clean them regularly.
Yeah.
But I mean, that's.
I don't know if
they're. I'm just saying that when you look at highways and so on, and you see almost like this, I mean, you see some real, I know that some stone was thrown here, but Jesus, I don't see any stone, you know, that amounts to, you know what I'm saying to you? I mean, I'm sorry, but.
Well, and you want cracks.
I mean, I don't even know if there's a load of stone been dumped here.
Well, and on top of that.
Am I right, Ron? Or maybe you saw something I didn't, so just speak up. I mean, don't let me babble on if I'm in the wrong direction, please.
We don't know what stone we dumped there. If we dumped round stone from our gravel bed, they could have rolled down the bank.
Well, I don't know where they went,
The catch is really putting in cracks, doing it right.
We're doing it right.
Half the crap.
That's right.
Cracked up stone that really don't move anywhere, and they break up the water flow.
And lay it right down.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, that might certainly would slow it down, but again, I think that's where, you know, to make up our mind and decide what we're going to do and go out to bid with it. We certainly don't have those stones over where we are.
Well, no, you buy them.
And the problem is, too, that we get out of our right of way, too. We go on to private property now.
Yeah. We have to get the okay. If you don't get the okay, you can't put it in.
I'm not sure if that's a fix. It may slow it down. You still have the same volume of water.
Well, the water is still going to flow down the hill. It's downhill.
Okay. But any time there's anything new put up nowadays, they insist upon settling ponds around the buildings. There was nothing done around the rescue squad to contain any of that water.
No.
All the water, I mean, maybe there could be something done maybe closer to that building to catch a bunch of that water so it could go into the ground. It can't go into blacktop. That's the problem. It can't go into metal roofs.
Yeah, that's where it's going. It's going right down the Lad Road, right down to Oak Hill Road, then down Oak Hill Road through these culverts. So it's doing.
There's no question there's no quick fix here.
Well, I think the first thing is we need to talk to this guy that came down and did a look. We need to ask him if we can tie in or not tie in, because we're looking at cost savings if we have to go that route. You know, rather than pay for, you know, 300 feet, let's pay for a couple hundred or 100 and a half.
Well,
let's make the difference. Well, that's the question
we
need
to ask.
Well,
it started out at 800.
Yeah, and if we cut it down to 300.
That's right.
Yeah, because about 150 between poles, and it was about three poles there.
Do you want me to contact Josh?
Yeah, contact Josh, and can we get somebody to...
To see where he left off on, because I know he was supposed to be... look into the rest of the sediment ponds, at least, anyway.
Yeah, well, I'll talk to him about what we're talking about, tying into the existing drainage that's there, if we can, because it would be a lot less,
I think along the, highway right there, I think that, some of that can be stone. I mean, I really believe in that. I mean, that's all you see, no matter, the state does it all the time, no matter where they go.
I took a picture there where stone is running in front of one of the houses.
I don't think we...
She might have it in her...
It might be over there.
She
doesn't like that we... I looked right at the culverts that day.
Stone in front of the house.
That's the one right there.
Okay, here's this one here. Yeah, that's the one you're talking about.
Yeah, which is, that's basically ditching in front of the person's house all the way.
That's right.
Basically what it is. And I think that's what you're talking about.
And this is round stone here, which you want...
You want a fractured stone.
Yeah, right. I think that's what you want.
Yeah, well, if you want to slow it down, you do. Otherwise, you're going to have stones rolling and blocking your drainage.
All along the route up to Stratton Mountain is done that way with all fractured stone.
It looks, I mean, to me, it looks nice.
The roads I'm driving
in New York State, that's what they do. They get that fractured stone. Just go off 22 and turn 7 there. You'll see it all.
We saw when we went to Boston.
So,
miles
of it.
So, but you can ask them that question too. What we're looking for is the engineer's expertise in helping us solve this. That's what I think. And then at that point, once he decides or helps us decide, then I'm saying
we'll find out the money.
We'll find out what the money is, and then make up our mind how we do it. It's just that we need to get it solved before next winter if we have a big snowfall and a large runoff. We were lucky this year. Besides, we saved some money, right? In the plowing, we might have a little bit of this.
We might have some.
So, hey.
Plenty, man. Have a nickel to give back.
Hopefully.
Wouldn't that be something?
Jeez, be nice. Be nice. Yeah. All right.
Town of Pownal seeks a full-time road foreman.
Can I make a comment before we close this?
Oh. Yeah, go ahead.
Yeah, we tried the stone thing on the backyard. It didn't work at all. I agree with you when you say that we have a climate change and maybe some more rain. But my problem went fivefold when we put in the rescue building. All of that water comes around, and it comes into the first drainage ditch, which comes into my backyard. I won't be happy with the water slowing down. I want it stopped. I've had enough of it. I've put up with it for enough years, and if we can't stop it this year, then I need somebody to come down and start fixing my driveway and fixing my backyard every time it flows over. I don't think I should have to keep drainage ditches in my yard anymore because of an illegal dumping of water. So again, I'm going to ask you to fix it. And don't put stone in, because that's not going to work for me. When it stopped.
Well, we'd have to ask you to put it on your property anyways, the stone.
We went through this too with sump lakes and ponds, and then I checked into that, and I have to put a fence around it and maintain it myself. Again, unacceptable.
At basically retention pond?
Yeah, well, the thing about it is like I say, I'm no engineer or anything else, but if we were able to divert, not slow down, if we were able to divert part of that water down through that other drainage system, I mean, I don't know how many gallons a minute is roaring down through there, but if you were able to divert half of it, it would probably make a big, big difference. And that's it. And all I'm looking at is, is ideas. If this thing is, there's only one way out, well, that's the way we go, the one way out. But if there is other options that we can, where we can save a dollar, I think we ought to try to do that for the, you know, the other taxpayers and whatever. Because we, I mean, it'd be good to control that, but I think if you're getting rid of a lot of it, you know, that's how they, when they put these settling ponds and stuff, they still put an overflow pipe on them. But the water has a chance to get to a spot and stay there and settle into the ground, and only a small amount goes out of the overflow. I'm just looking at different options. I mean, people can agree and not agree. That's what we're here for, to talk about it and see what happens.
Well, I think we're on the right track. We're not saying that we're going to design this.
No.
We're asking.
Right? So don't, you know, we're just talking what we see. Now we're going to have somebody come and say, hey, listen, yes, it'll work, no, it won't work.
And what about me? What do I do about my backyard and my driveway? Do I have to live like that for another year?
Well, hopefully not. We're
going to talk to... Would I be compensated for that?
We're talking with somebody right now to try and find a solution.
Last meeting I was at, I was promised it was going to go out to bid.
Didn't happen.
And we agreed on that. Now we're receding that?
No, first of all, that misunderstanding there, because we had nothing to put out for bid.
There was a lack of information.
We didn't have a plan, engineered plan, or a drawing. All we had was a material list that our previous road foreman went and got for us, and to figure if we were to go down that route. But it was not engineered and passed and accepted or anything else.
Yeah, the state would have to approve it.
The state has to approve whatever we do anyway, to start with. But I mean, we had no print to put out there, you know. In order to put something out to bid, you've got to have...
It wasn't approved to put it out to bid?
Huh?
It wasn't approved that you put it out to bid?
Not by the state.
No, we didn't have anything to put out to bid.
No, it was withdrawn because there was nothing there. There was nothing there we could put to bid.
Oh, that was after I left.
We talked about putting it out to bid.
We talked about putting it out to bid, but
we
talked about it some more and said, look, you can't put something out to bid if you don't have a plan.
Just the other thing to consider is lawyer's fees, okay?
Is what?
Lawyer's fees.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yep.
Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Did we notify our insurance company of this?
Not yet.
We should notify them of this possible issue. Just so they're... It might be nothing to do at this time, but they basically need to know. I would just call them and say, hey, look, here's an incident we have. Here's what we're threatened with. We just want to make you aware of it. That way they can't say we're not reporting it.
Oh, no, you want to...
Well, actually, tonight he stated possible legal action,
yeah.
So that's
yeah.
Enough for them to...
Yeah.
We're not saying that there is or there isn't, but there is a possibility, I believe. That's
yeah,
what I hear.
And we as board members, our duty is to report as quickly as possible to our insurance company in a timely fashion.
So do we hire an engineer to come in and look at it and draw it up for us so we can put it...
I want to hear from the state first.
I think you better start with Josh first.
Okay.
Yeah.
And then once we get that information, then we can go from there. Because we need to hear... I don't even know if we can tie in. If we can tie in, then that's... If we can't, then we have to do a different plan. Let's see what it is. And you were talking about road foreman position?
How long has this problem been going on?
Years.
Years.
Okay. Years and
years.
Oh,
okay.
Been going on a long time.
I just wanted to verify that.
We put temporary... We put solutions in that we thought would take care of it, and it's proved to be only temporary.
Okay.
I think that's the best way to say it.
Yeah, very good. Nope, just that's
fine. We thought we fixed it.
It didn't.
Popped up.
Not satisfactory, right?
So anyway, we should have a road foreman position. Be a full-time job. Duties include personnel management, maintenance, repair and construction of town highways, bridges, facilities, and equipment. Snow and ice removal. Purchasing supplies, developing and managing budgets, job safety, interacting with the public, and project planning. The road foreman supervises a three-man road crew and contractors as necessary. Requires a CDL, the Class B minimum with air brake endorsement. High school diploma or equivalent experience in highway maintenance or equivalent construction experience. Computer skills and extensive knowledge of highway construction procedures and methods. Must pass a physical exam and drug testing. Salary compensate with experience and excellent benefit package. To apply, send a confidential letter of interest detailing experience and qualifications, plus 3 references to Pownal Board of Selectmen, road foreman position, P.O. Box 411, Pownal, Vermont, 05261, or email pownalx@comcast.net.
Pownal LCS@comcast.net.
Pownal LCS, that's what it is?
Yes.
Okay, that's beautiful. You should separate it a
little bit. Very good.
You should separate it a little bit.
Does 2 weeks sound like that's enough time?
One thing, I don't know if it's enough time, but one of the things I would like to do, because we see them all the time, is the Vermont Leagues of Cities and Towns put out their weekly flyer or whatever it is. I would like that to
go monthly.
I like that to go in their flyer, because you never know who's in the state that could be very qualified and be in somewhere in there, like everybody, like our road foreman, they're looking for another job once in a while.
That's right, and they are probably, and they may even be willing to relocate.
That's right. Well, that's part of the requirement.
I didn't see nothing about 2 weeks anyway. It's just
I'm asking.
Yeah,
just asking.
We need to establish.
Yeah, I would say I want to run it in this. You can agree with this, but I think we need to run it so it goes out in the state. Then nobody can say we hung it locally and you're not asking for the people. Let's do it. And then at the end of that time, if it takes 5 weeks, I don't know how long.
So is it okay to leave position open until it's filled in? Is that
I think the board moved earlier to let the person that's there, Mr. Lampman, fill in right now.
Just the day-to-day duties, but no paperwork.
And if that works, then I think we can watch it for a week or two. And if it doesn't, then we'll have to do something. But I think right now, let's wait and see and get this ad out.
Yeah, I think we'll. Yeah.
That's it. It's got to get out there. I mean, and maybe.
Well, one good thing. We're not pressed with a tremendous snowstorm, or maybe we might get one. It's still possible. But
well, it's supposed to be 20 Monday.
That's right. No, it's possible. But all I'm saying is, we're not in the fall. We're not in September, October.
No.
Okay. So that I think we've got some time here. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I think so too. And if it doesn't work out with what we got there at the moment, then I think we need to bring it back up and address that. Because there might be other options out there.
Right. No, I think that if things start falling apart, we need to move.
Okay.
Or we'll get a part-timer until we
want, or
do something.
That's right.
Okay.
And I'm sure to
leave it open.
Yep.
Okay.
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 Okay. Anything else? Nothing else? I'll make a motion to adjourn.
I think I want to go to, I want to, number one, mention the website's up and running.
Yeah, it's looking a little better.
Good start.
We took a look at it today, Dave Adams did, and because someone called to see if the town report was online, and it is.
Okay. The other thing is I'd like to discuss personnel and contracts and executives.
How does it mean?
Personnel contacts or what?
In executive session.
Oh, okay. Well, when the executive session?
I move to do that.
Okay, second?
I'll second. Not sure what it's
all
about.
All in favor? All right, we'll be on my
list. Oh, personnel, right?
Yes, it is, yes. Yep.
Personnel,
yes.
Functions, duties?
Yes, contracts.
Contracts? Okay. Okay, are we going to make any decisions?
Jason and who?
I second it. Are we going to make any decisions? Or?
I think we are. We've got to discuss the temporary foreman.
Okay.